Welcome to Blue's Investment. Today's 3-minute video is an analyst view on the Genting Singapore. Genting released the Q1 earnings on May 7th and the four analysts released their views. Q1 earnings, all four say below expectations. Only CIB comment like a revenue growth within expectations. All four call like outlook is not good. All reduce their future earnings as most of the pessimistic one is a Maybank. Maybank reduced FY21 earning 59%, 22 is a 45%. Now they think like EBITDA FY21 is a 430 million only, EBITDA 22 is a 680 million only. Most optimistic one is a maybe UOB. They reduced FY21 is a by 31%, this is a lot, but retained the FY22 EBITDA. So FY22 EBITDA is a 1230 million. What their call is a CIMB call add is a $1 is a their target price. Maybank call hold $0.86 is a their target price. They actually released their view twice, the May 9th and the May 19th, even after the May 14th when the mini circuit breaker start. Also May 17th, the Yokohama IR information came in. They still call like 86 cents. DBS call buy 95 cents. UOB Kay Hian call like a buy 1.08. Most optimistic one. Maybank talking about two big investment. Result one Sentosa expansion. They think like a positive because it expand not only gaming but also non-gaming capacity. Yokohama IR, I think their position is more neutral. They update the status. Genting Singapore well positioned to win the RFP process in summer. Competitors are Melco, Sega, Sammy, Shotok. Is a Galaxy like a withdraw this competition. This deal may add up to the Singapore dollar $0.6 per share to target price. Biggest risk is the August 22 major election in Yokohama. Other critical factors CIMB mentioned about margin fall could be due to the tapering government support like a JSS scheme and operation cost rise. Maybank say like a bad debt, maybe the risk is the most profitable customer VIP is the most Chinese, but gambling debt are not enforceable in China. They also mentioned about regional expansion. Is mainly they talk about Yokohama IR. Is they said like Genting Singapore doesn't know what happened in the new region, and also Genting Singapore has to borrow a lot of money on that. DBS said extension of existing COVID-19 measures or introduction of a strict restriction as a part of the risk. This actually happens after May 14th. UOB Kay Hian mentioned about as an upside as a dividend. Dividend yield expect to the normalize to 4.1% in the 2022. And this H2 is a 3.5 cent projected. This is equivalent to around 4%. This is better than H1. Thanks for your company. Have a good deal and a good day.